Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening, welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Shreya Vijay. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Tuesday, the 12th of January. India starts delivering shots for world's biggest vaccination drive. Pakistan's opposition termed drive against Imran Khan-led government as jihad. And US troop drawdown from Afghanistan despite ongoing restrictions. And now for all the details. With just few days left before India starts its nationwide vaccination drive, the first consignment of Covishield vaccine was dispatched from Western Pune city early on Tuesday. The vaccines were later in the day delivered across the country. India started delivering batches of COVID-19 vaccines to several cities across the country early on Tuesday, ahead of its campaign to offer shots to 1.3 billion people in what officials call the world's biggest vaccination drive. The first consignment was dispatched from the Serum Institute of India in Western Pune city. A prayer ceremony was held just before the first few trucks carrying the vaccine left for Pune International Airport.
So it was a great day, and we celebrated the trucks going out early this morning. And now the real challenge for 2021 is to get as much product out there to the most vulnerable sections. And, you know, hopefully, as we've seen, that's going on smoothly, and we hope to vaccinate a large population in India in the coming months.
A total of 8 flights were scheduled on Tuesday to transport the Covishield vaccine, developed by AstraZeneca and Oxford University, to 13 different locations. The first flight ferrying COVID-19 vaccines reached the national capital, New Delhi, with the first consignment. Southern Hyderabad, Bengaluru and eastern Kolkata cities were among others who got the doses of Covishield later in the day. India as of Tuesday afternoon recorded only 12,584 new COVID-19 cases in the last 24 hours, the lowest case spike in 7 months. India's Supreme Court on Tuesday suspended implementation of the 3 new farm laws until further orders and said it will form a committee to hold talks with all stakeholders. The laws that liberalise agriculture sector have triggered protests by thousands of farmers at Delhi's borders since over a month.
India's Supreme Court ordered an indefinite stay on Tuesday over the implementation of new agricultural laws that have triggered widespread protest from farmers. Chief Justice S.A. Bobde told a hearing the Supreme Court would establish a panel to hear the farmers' grievances who have been protesting at borders of Indian capital New Delhi since over a month.
और कमेटी गठित हो गई, कुछ नाम सुझाए गए हैं, उन नामों के आधार पर आगे प्रोसीडिंग होगी. आज माननीय सर्वोच्च न्यायालय ने तीनों कृषि कानूनों के खिलाफ, जिनके खिलाफ हमारी याचिकाएं थी जो चल रही थी, उन तीनों कानूनों पर ऑनरेबल सुप्रीम कोर्ट ऑफ इंडिया ने स्टे लगा दिया गया है.
Tens of thousands of farmers have camped on the outskirts of New Delhi since late November to demand the repeal of the laws that they say benefit large private buyers and harm growers.
ਇਸ ਅੰਦੋਲਨ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਅਸੀਂ ਅੱਤ ਦੀ ਗਰਮੀ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ, ਅੱਤ ਦੀ ਸਰਦੀ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਰਹੇ ਹਾਂ, ਆਪਣੇ ਜਾਨ ਦੀ ਮਾਲੀ ਨੁਕਸਾਨ ਕਰਵਾਏ ਆ, ਅਤੇ ਇਹਦੇ ਦੇ 70 ਤੋਂ ਵੱਧ ਅਸੀਂ ਮੌਤਾਂ ਜਿਹੜੀਆਂ ਸਾਡੇ ਕਿਸਾਨਾਂ ਦੀਆਂ ਹੋ ਚੁੱਕੀਆਂ, ਬਲੀਦਾਨ ਹੋ ਚੁੱਕਾ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦਾ, ਪਰ ਜਿਹੜਾ 4 ਮਹੀਨੇ ਤੋਂ ਬਾਅਦ ਆਣ ਕੇ ਇਹਨੂੰ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਵਾ ਸਸਪੈਂਡ ਕਰਨਾ, ਫਿਰ ਉਹਦੇ ਉੱਤੇ ਕਮੇਟੀ ਬਣਾਉਣੀ, ਇਹ ਕੋਈ ਹੁਣ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਵਾ ਇਹ ਬਣਦਾ ਨੀਗਾ.
ਪ੍ਰਾਈਮ ਮਿਨਿਸਟਰ ਨਰਿੰਦਰ ਮੋਦੀਜ਼ ਗਵਰਨਮੈਂਟ ਹੈਜ਼ ਸੈਡ ਦੇਅਰ ਵਾਜ਼ ਨੋ ਕੁਐਸਚਨ ਆਫ ਅ ਰੋਲ ਬੈਕ ਆਫ ਦੀ ਲਾਜ਼ ਦੈਟ ਏਮ ਟੂ ਮਾਡਰਨਾਈਜ਼ an antiquated farming system. A 9th round of talks between the government and farmer unions is set to take place on Friday.
In news from Pakistan, Chief of Pakistan Democratic Movement, Maulana Fazlur Rehman, on Monday termed the opposition's strife against Prime Minister Imran Khan-led government as jihad or holy war. The opposition has intensified its rallies and warned of a long march to Islamabad if Khan does not resign by 31st of January.
Pakistan Democratic Movement or PDM chief Maulana Fazlur Rehman has termed the 11-party alliance's drive against the incumbent government of Prime Minister Imran Khan a jihad or holy war. At a PDM rally organized at Malakand in Khyber Pakhtunkhwa, Rehman declared that nation is ready to offer any sacrifice for this cause and it would continue till rulers stopped oppressing the poor. He said that there was no democracy in the country and government was conspiring against the constitution and provinces, and martial law is in place, which is worse than eras of General Zia and General Pervez Musharraf. Pakistan People's Party Chairman Bilawal Bhutto Zardari said the PDM rally was a referendum against the selected government, which has ruined the economy with ill-planned policies. The PDM has been leading a campaign against the Imran Khan-led government to quit by January 31 or face intensified movements, including a long march to Islamabad.
Moving on, Jamaat-e-Islami Party in Pakistan's Karachi city recently held a protest against frequent gas load shedding. The protesters blamed government's negligence for the plight of locals as their gas supply has been hampered with unprecedented severity and authorities are not taking any action despite promising people of consistent supply of gas during winter. Members of Jamaat-e-Islami, a political party in Pakistan's largest city of Karachi, recently carried out a protest against the government as locals experience frequent gas load shedding in the city. The protesters said their city is deprived of consistent and committed gas pressure even after the federal government's assurance of uninterrupted gas supply in winter months. PM Imran Khan-led government in Pakistan had committed in October last year to provide consistent supply of gas to Karachi industries during winter months to avoid low pressure and gas load shedding issues. This comes as government in Karachi has also increased gas prices like electricity. Jamaat-e-Islami has now warned of starting a sit-in movement if the issues are not resolved. In news from Afghanistan, Afghan President Ashraf Ghani, while referring to a recent airstrike in Nimroz province, has said the Taliban and other groups are using people's houses and public places as shields, which is the main reason behind civilian casualties. This comes as negotiations being held between the Afghan government and the Taliban in Doha are not progressing much, according to local media reports.
2 days after an airstrike in Nimroz reportedly killed 18 civilians, all members of one family, Afghan President Ashraf Ghani on Monday sent a message of condolence to the families of those killed, as well as to the residents and elders of the southwestern province. President Ghani did not mention the number of those who lost their lives in the airstrike, but said that the Taliban and other terror groups are using people's houses and public places as shields, which is the main reason behind civilian casualties and is a consequence of war and is not acceptable. This comes as local media reports suggest there is no breakthrough in the negotiations being held between the Afghan government and the Taliban since last week in Doha. Meanwhile, the High Council for National Reconciliation stated that attempts to find a solution to unify the agenda are underway.
More on news from Afghanistan. The U.S. military has not halted a U.S. troop withdrawal from Afghanistan despite a new law prohibiting further reductions without the Pentagon sending Congress an assessment of the risk. This comes amid concerns over a surge in violence in Afghanistan.
The U.S. military has not halted a U.S. troop withdrawal from Afghanistan, the Department of Defense told Reuters news agency on Monday, despite a new law prohibiting further reductions without the Pentagon sending Congress an assessment of the risks. Currently, no new orders have been issued which impact the progression of the conditions-based drawdown expected to reach 2,500 troops by January 15, 2021, it said in a statement. The Congress enacted a defense policy bill this month, overriding a veto by President Donald Trump that bars using funds appropriated for fiscal years 2020 and 2021 to pay for a drawdown below 4,000 U.S. troops until submission of comprehensive interagency assessment of the risks and impacts. Halting the drawdown could jeopardize the U.S.-backed Afghanistan peace process, as a February 2020 agreement with the Taliban calls for a complete U.S. troop withdrawal by May 2021 in return for the insurgents fulfilling security guarantees. Some officials have reportedly urged Trump not to cut the force amid a surge in violence in Afghanistan, and what they said was the Taliban's failure to end cooperation with Al-Qaeda.
Moving on to news from Nepal. Chairpersons of the rival faction of the Nepal Communist Party or NCP pushed Kamal Dehal and Madhav Kumar Nepal on Monday, urged the Election Commission to stop preparations for midterm polls, calling them meaningless as the dissolution of the parliament was sub judice. On December 20, Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli dissolved the parliament and announced snap polls in April and May, citing internal rift within his party as reasons behind his decision. Meanwhile, on Monday, clashes were reported between demonstrators asking to restore constitutional monarchy in Nepal and police during the celebrations of Unification Day of the country. Oli's move has triggered a wave of street protests that have deepened the ongoing political crisis in the Himalayan nation. People of Bangladesh over the past weekend celebrated the homecoming day of their country's founding father, Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, by carrying out a marathon race. Rahman, in 1972, returned to Bangladesh after his release by Pakistan following the emergence of Bangladesh as an independent country.
Bangladeshi capital Dhaka over the past weekend held a marathon race to observe the homecoming day of Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, the country's founding father. About 200 runners from Bangladesh and other countries and regions participated in the race, which was inaugurated by Bangladeshi Home Minister Asaduzzaman Khan Kamal. On January 10, 1972, Rahman returned to Bangladesh via London and New Delhi after his release by Pakistan following the emergence of Bangladesh as an independent country. He spent 9.5 months in a Pakistani jail. Rahman was born in March 1920 and was assassinated in August 1975. He was the first Prime Minister of independent Bangladesh.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude, the top stories once again. India starts delivering shots for world's biggest vaccination drive. Pakistan's opposition termed drive against Imran Khan-led government as jihad. And US troop drawdown from Afghanistan despite ongoing restrictions. Now, viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on Facebook.com/SAsiaNewsline and follow us on Twitter @SAsiaNewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. subscribe TAG TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.